This is a story about a raven couple, and this is the male. One morning of deep cold, he was there looking, so I brought him a piece of fat. He has come each morning since. This is his mate, a very flighty creature. She took many months to come for a morsel on her own. Often he caressed her affectionately. They did not seem to be a young couple, and I'm sure that they have seen a lot of good and bad times together. They certainly seem to be in love. As the snow melted, this is how they were together before she began two disastrous attempts to hatch their eggs. The first clutch was destroyed by crows, and the second did not hatch. The male left when she settled on their eggs, and she was so secretive that no one could have guessed that there was a raven there. She descended to the house once every few days for some sustenance. 3 weeks had passed when he flew in again, and their chicks were already overdue. He took the bit of food, went straight to his distressed mate, and fed her. Later, it was clear that she had abandoned the nest. The birds were together all the time, and I could hear them calling and cooing to each other from the house. He would come early for their helpings of food and seemed absolutely devoted to her. She was perched high above us in a tree and paid no attention. So naturally, he loaded up fast. It was funny to watch how he managed to pack up all the food in his beak. Ravens are just expert at this, and I had given him enough food for both of them. Each morning for the next few days, he came for food. He walked all the way down to the house, took the little bit I gave him, carried it to where she waited above, and fed her. But after a few days had passed, he no longer seemed so willing to attend to her, and one morning, he took certain pieces and hid them for later. Then he came back for the rest. When he left, he passed by her. Yet in the end, As she flies away, you can see that she has most of the food in her beak, while he is hiding another morsel for later. Finally, he took the food and flew away, leaving her standing there in the road. She began to call, the low sound she usually only made with him. She alighted in one of the trees, still calling. Finally, she flew. She alighted on a branch overlooking the valley where she continued to call. He returned just 2 hours later and fed her, but it really looked as if he was getting tired of her crying. Then the skies cleared and they left. I was sure that while traveling, the female would settle down and begin eating herself as usual. So on the morning they returned, 3 days later, I got the camera ready. And he is still feeding her. I have known this couple now for 2 years and have never seen him feed her before this period, after she had lost her eggs.